Hi, my name is Dan the Flash and I'm a park interpreter with Santa Clara County Parks. It's my job to share the cultural, historical, and natural resource stories that our parks have to offer with the visitors and members of our community.
In 1845, Andreas Castellero roasted crushed local cinnabar and produced mercury. While many call California the Golden State after the 1848 gold rush began, it might better be called the Quicksilver State. Without quicksilver, also known as mercury, the majority of gold found in the Sierra Nevada mountains would have remained locked in ore bodies and been worthless. Mercury has a superpower. It separates gold from the waste rock. But how does it do that? Once the easy-to-find solid nuggets of gold in stream beds were depleted, gold needed to be mined from larger chunks of rock, such as quartz, basalt, or granite in which it was embedded. One of the most common ways to release gold was to crush rock in a stamp mill that was 20 to 30 feet tall and had up to 10 iron shoes weighing 450 to 900 pounds. The shoes crushed the rock, producing a coarse sand with gold particles. Mercury is poured over the sand, and the gold is absorbed into the mercury, creating an amalgam that looks like silver putty. To release the gold, the amalgam is heated in an iron retort between 700 to 1000 degrees for several hours. When mercury reaches its boiling point, it turns into a gas. When the retort is opened, gold is left behind. For gold prospectors, the resulting gold was what drove them to toil away with pickaxes and dynamite, sleeping in canvas tents for weeks with a trusty shotgun as your tent mate. For the mine managers of the Quicksilver Mining Company and other mercury mines, the liquid mercury was in their own form of gold. The supply of mercury was carefully regulated to increase their profits. If the supply of mercury was low, profits gained were high. For the early owners of Quicksilver Mining Company, laborers who toiled underground and breathed noxious furnace fumes were akin to gold's waste rock, or the spent cinnabar ore, to be used and tossed away. However, as lower grades of cinnabar ore were more frequently found and stockholders were less inclined to invest in infrastructure, in the 1870s and 1880s, mine manager J.B. Randall began to see his employees as a valuable asset, much like the mercury itself. If care is taken, the evaporating mercury vapor can be condensed, collected, and used again. Since the greatest cost of mercury mining is paying laborers, J.B. Randall needed to take care of his workforce. Join us for our next episode where we learn about the mining communities that labored in the New Almaden Hills and their resiliency in the face of hardships.
Now, should you choose to visit the parks, be sure to bring plenty of water, some sturdy shoes, and maybe a mask, just in case you're on some narrow trails. And if you're not feeling well, it might be best just to stay home.
If our video series sparks your interest, and you wish to visit the New Almaden Quicksilver Mining Museum, located in the historic Casa Grande, please consult the Almaden Quicksilver Museum webpage at parkhere.org for current visiting hours.